Hi, how are you? This is Brando, and this time I will talk to you about the tense present progressive. Okay, this is a very important and used tense in the English language, and I'll explain to you its structure and also the ways in which you can use them in affirmative, negative, and interrogative sentences. Okay, first, the structure. Okay. With the structure, it's very simple. You only have to take the subject, the verb to be, and then you have to add the verb, the main verb of the sentence, in ing form, and then you have the complement. Okay, let me give you an example. I am speaking with you. That's the structure. The subject, I, the verb to be in present, am, the verb, the main verb in ing form, speaking, and the complement, with you. Okay? Very simple. So, depending on the verb, depending on the personal pronoun that you're using or the person that you are referring to, you have to conjugate the verb to be in a different way. You can say, he is speaking with you. She is speaking with you. You are speaking with me. We are speaking with you. They are speaking with you. Okay? That is the way in which you structure the present progressive in affirmative phrases. In negative, you only have to add the word not after the verb to be. I am not speaking with you. You are not speaking with me. She is not speaking with you. He is not speaking with you. We are not speaking with you. They are not speaking with you. Okay? In questions, it's very simple too, because you have to change the position of the verb of the personal pronoun or the person you are referring to and the verb to be. So you say, am I speaking with you? Are you speaking with me? Is she speaking with you? Is he speaking with you? Are we speaking with you? Are they speaking with you? Okay, that's the way in which you structure a question within present progressive. But what do you use it for? What is the use? Present progressive is used to talk about something that is happening right now. Okay, right now I am talking with you. Right now I am looking at the camera. Right now I am moving my hand, okay? Something that is happening right now. Also, it's used to talk about an action that is going to happen in a very short period of time. I am going to my mom's house, okay? So remember that the ways in which you use the present progressive is the verb to be, ing form. It's very, very important for you to remember these two things, the verb to be and the main verb of the sentence in ing form. This was present progressive. Thank you very much. See you next time. Hola, soy Brando y en esta ocasión te voy a hablar de present progressive, que es el presente continuo, present progressive or present continuous. Okay? Te voy a explicar la estructura de este tiempo verbal en frases afirmativas, negativas, interrogativas, y también te voy a explicar el uso. ¿Cuál es la estructura? Se comienza con el sujeto, el verbo to be en presente, el verbo principal de la frase con ing y luego el complemento. Como por ejemplo, tenemos I am looking at you, or I am watching TV. Okay? I, sujeto, am, verb to be, verbo to be en presente, watching, el verbo de la frase, el verbo principal, TV, complemento, yo estoy viendo televisión. Como en español decimos yo estoy, tú estás, nosotros estamos, así es igual en inglés, I am, y también tenemos viendo, esa terminación yendo, en inglés es ing, ing. Watching, looking, talking, speaking. ¿Ok? I am watching, yo estoy viendo televisión, TV. Es muy parecido al español. Y dependiendo de la persona a la que se esté hablando, el verbo to be cambia. Si yo digo I am watching, yo estoy viendo, you are watching, tú estás viendo, she is watching, ella está viendo, he is watching, él está viendo, we are watching, nosotros estamos viendo, they are watching, ellos están viendo. Solamente cambia el verbo to be porque el verbo principal de la frase siempre es watching, reading, talking, walking. ¿Okay? Eso nunca cambia, lo que cambia es el verbo to be. Are, is o am, dependiendo de la persona a la que se esté refiriendo. Eso es en frases afirmativas. En frases negativas simplemente se le agrega not después del verbo to be. I am not watching, yo no estoy viendo. You're not watching, tú no estás viendo. She is not watching, ella no está viendo. He is not watching, él no está viendo. We are not watching, nosotros no estamos viendo. They are not watching, ellos no están viendo. En el caso de las preguntas, más fácil todavía, solamente se cambia la posición del verbo to be y el pronombre personal. Am I watching? Estoy viendo. Are you watching? Estás viendo. Is she watching? Ella está viendo. Is he watching? Él está viendo. Are we watching? Nosotros estamos viendo. Are they watching? Ellos están viendo. Así que es muy muy sencillo. Se dice are they watching? Are they? Are you? Is she? Is he? Y luego el verbo en ing. Eso es muy importante que no se le puede olvidar. No puedes olvidar colocar la ing al final del verbo y utilizar el verbo to be. ¿Okay? ¿Cuándo se utiliza este tiempo verbal? Este tiempo verbal se utiliza cuando se va a hablar de algo que está ocurriendo en este momento. I am talking. Estoy hablando. I am moving my hand. Estoy moviendo la mano. I am breathing, estoy respirando. ¿Ok? Algo que está ocurriendo en este exacto momento, porque es una acción continua que está pasando. También se utiliza para hablar de algo que va a pasar en el futuro, pero un futuro muy cercano. I am going to my house, yo voy a mi casa. ¿Ok? Un futuro no muy lejano. I am going to my house, voy a mi casa. Bueno, esta es la forma en la que se utiliza el tiempo verbal presente continuo. Espero les haya sido muy útil. Recuerden que se tiene que utilizar el verbo to be conjugado correctamente con el pronombre personal o la persona que se está refiriendo y el verbo principal de la frase en la forma ing. Espero les haya gustado y que les haya sido útil. Nos vemos en la próxima.